Graham Giusa Matthews here from Bleacher Report, sitting here with WWE Raw superstar Damian Priest. Damian, what's going on, man?
Oh, my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Nice to meet you. We got SummerSlam this weekend. You're going for the United States Championship. I just talked to Drew Drop, and she just debuted on Raw a matter of months ago. You debuted on Raw at the beginning of the year. To go from that to then SummerSlam, obviously you're at WrestleMania. You're in the Royal Rumble. But you're competing in front of 50,000 people tomorrow for the United States Championship. I mean, take me through that a little bit.
What a ride.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Like, yeah, I mean, you could hope and you could wish and you could dream all you want, but I think in the back of everybody's mind, you don't really think you're going to achieve any of that because that's you know, movies. Like, that's not real life. But yet, here we are, and I'm psyched. Like, this entire year so far has been nothing but gold as far as, like, the type of lifestyle I've gotten to live. Mm-hmm. And now I got a chance to actually win gold. So it's man, it's beautiful.
And almost exactly a year removed from when you won the NXT North American Championship. That anniversary, I think, is on Sunday, if I'm not mistaken. So it could be almost exactly 1 year in between you winning gold.
I mean, I'm like literally Captain America.
I guess so. And it's cool, too, because, you know, after you won the North American title, everyone saw the picture of you winning the championship in the hot tub right after you won it. Amazing title win, Triple H finger point, everything. We're in Vegas right now. It's got to be very fitting for you to win the championship in Vegas, right, if you were to win tomorrow?
It makes sense. I mean, it's like it was meant to be. That's the way I feel about it, at least. You know, yeah, Damian Priest wins championship in Vegas at SummerSlam. It just sounds right.
Yeah. It just sounds right. I mean, let's say you win tomorrow, beat Sheamus for the championship. What's the first thing that you do? I mean, people go to Disney World, but we're in Vegas right now. What do you do?
I'm definitely not going to Disney World.
Okay.
Yeah,
especially in the midst of a pandemic, too. That's a different story.
Yeah, let's just say Damian Priest is a little bit more adult-orientated.
Sure.
But you know what? I haven't actually made a full plan yet.
Yep.
I think it's just going to be one of those things to see, like, wherever the craziness takes me, that'll be where I celebrate.
Yeah. It's going to be crazy, and it's such a cool matchup, too. You and Sheamus for only the second time ever, because we saw for the first time on Raw a few weeks ago. Your thoughts on Sheamus as an adversary, the matches you guys had, the first match you guys had a couple of weeks ago, you guys had really good chemistry that first time.
So, you know what's cool is that Sheamus, I mean, you're talking about a guy whose Hall of Fame career, right? You know, all his accolades. He's been in this company for years. Yeah. I think people forget how long he's been in this company.
Over a decade.
And he's been relevant the entire time.
Yeah.
Yet, this is the best version of Sheamus, in my opinion. And I get to work with that guy, with that version, at SummerSlam. It means the world to me.
Favorite SummerSlam memories? Growing up a wrestling fan, obviously being from the New York area. Any favorite SummerSlam memories come to mind?
Highway to Hell. There's this Austin Taker. I was there in Madison Square Garden. So that alone, like that, I remember the poster was super cool, you know? And then like, that to me, that was a good one. I'm disappointed that Taker didn't win. I was a big Taker guy, but that was my fondest memory as far as a SummerSlam goes.
Have you been able to compete in MSG so far in your time in WWE, NXT, main roster yet or not yet?
Negative. The most I did, I got to be an extra one time at a live event years ago. I think it was 2014 maybe.
Mm-hmm.
But that was it. I've never wrestled. I've never had an entrance. I've never done anything like that in Madison Square Garden. And hopefully now, because as a kid, I went to countless events at Madison Square Garden. So it'd be kind of neat to be on the other side, you know, one day and see my hometown.
I mean, what else is on the bucket list at this point? Obviously competing in MSG, like you just said, but you debut in the Rumble, have a strong showing, you team with Bad Bunny of all people at WrestleMania and win, and now you have a U.S. title match at SummerSlam. Like, are we going to see you in the Universal title picture come Survivor Series? Like, what's up with that?
I mean, that'd be sweet.
No complaints, right?
Negative. Yeah, it's, like, you're right. I mean, it's been wild, all the positive things that I've been doing and that have happened to me, but I see it as like a ladder. Like I have to keep climbing. I have to have more. I need more, and I have to strive for the very top. And even if I don't make it there, it'll be cool to see what I can achieve just trying.
Yeah.
So that's where I'm at right now. I'm like every day or every week, or every month, I try to do something more and try to create another moment. You know, because that's how you build a legacy. That's how, in Damian Priest terms, your name lives forever, you know, and that's the goal. And first step, United States Championship.
It's going to be a great match, you and Sheamus, tomorrow night at Allegiant Stadium at SummerSlam. Damian, thanks so much for the time,
man.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.